You are now live.
Hey guys, Frank here. And I have something amazing to share with you guys. You know the new Skyport that was just being released? Makes it possible with Canon and Nikon to 125th of a second ratio.
Sorry. Yes.
Something went wrong. Okay. Hey, you know that new Skyport that has just been released that breaks the barrier of 125th of a second? So you can shoot up to 1/8000th of a second with your iSync? Awesome, right? But not for Sony. Only Canon and Nikon. Well, one guy on my blog actually gave me an idea and I just tested it out. And this is for all you guys with Sony. This is amazing, stunning and awesome. This is the Odin from Fotix, right? Normally you use this for small flash, for example, with your Mitros or with your Mitros Plus. So it's the steering unit. Now, if you don't use high speed sync, and you have it on your camera, you can actually also, and if you follow me here, you can connect your Fotix Odin receiver on, for example, a D-Lite, like you see here. Now, as soon as I take a shot, and let me take a shot on 125th, 5.6, I'm just going to take a shot off the wall. Okay, there we go. Very nice. You see the wall, right? So, nothing spectacular there. That's how it's supposed to be working. You just trigger your strobes. Now watch this. If I go up in shutter speed, I can actually go up to 1/250th of a second. So I can't go any higher. That's because I don't use high speed sync. So let's take another shot. And there we go. The same wall. Nothing spectacular. Now watch this. Now I'm going to switch on my high speed sync on this. And now I can go all the way up, and let's just try for fun, 1/1600th of a second. Now normally, if you don't use high speed sync, you will get, of course, a totally black image, because very simple, it doesn't work, because you have that 125th of a second rule. Now let's try this. Much to my surprise, there we have the gray wall. Now, of course, there's light loss, without any doubt. But that's normal with a system like this. It also does it with the Ellengrams. So you have to lower it down, 2.8. There we go. I'm shooting on 1600th of a second. And having a beautiful white wall with no barriers, which are normally prone if you shoot on a higher shutter speed. So let's try it all the way up. 1/8000th of a second, 2.8. And I guess I now have to go to ISO 400 to get something usable. So let's go to ISO 400, do the same thing. 1/8000th of a second using strobes on an Ellengrom D-Lite 4 with the Fotix Odin, probably something you already have, or if you have a Sony, something you should buy. And of course, you need a receiver also on the D-Lite, but this is on a D-Lite 4. On other systems where you have a faster flash duration, just like with the Ellengrom, it won't work. For the very simple reason, the slower the stroke, the better the system works. The faster the stroke, the less it works. Now, how do you fine tune it? Very simple, you press the mode key and the plus key on your Odin, and you can fine tune your ODS setting. Now, in this combination, I use 2.7. It is standard on zero, and then you lose a lot of light. But if you go all the way up to 2.7, well, as you can see, 1/8000th of a second, 2.8, and I'm getting a perfectly exposed image. So, you still have to wait, of course, for the Ellengrom D-Lite, for the Ellengrom Skyport, because that one can control your strobes from a distance. You can see what your strobes are doing. They talk back to each other. But if you want to work on location with your Ellengrom strobes and a Sony camera on that really high shutter speeds, or any other brand, check out these Fotix Odins, because, well, you just get a receiver, you put it on any strobe you want, as long as it has a slower flash duration, and you use your steering unit, and you can go all the way up to 1/8000th of a second and really fight that sun outside. Now, to prove I'm not kidding around, I will turn this off. So there's no strobe now. I will aim at my wall, take a picture, and it's pitch black. Turn it on again. There we go.
Will the Fotix system work on other cameras than Sony?
There we go. The Fotix system has different triggers for both Canon and Nikon. and of course also Sony. I don't know if it will work the same on Canon and Nikon, but I don't see why not, because it's built in the Fotix. You do need the newest firmware, but that's available on their website. So we'll write something on social media about it. But for Sony lovers, this is amazing, because now we still have to wait for the Elangrom Skyport, of course, because that one will totally blast this away with lots more options. But now at least we can also try it and use it in our system. And if you already have a system like this, you can use it now. So thank you very much for watching, guys. And I will post something on social media about it that you saw it first on Periscope.